This is Hyrule Total War, Classic Ultimate. It's my submod for Undying Nephilim's old version released in December 2014. The backstory of this mod is quite long. He started work on the mod in 2009 and he released a custom battles only version in the spring of 2011. The first version with a campaign were released during the fall of 2012, and since that date I've played I used to play the campaign from like I believe September 2012 to like December 2014, and there were like updates each half year, so he would release one update in December and one during the summer. So I was a huge fan of this mod, and I didn't like the change of models because I liked the style of the older models. So I didn't update the Hyrule Total War version that I had in December of 2014. Also, I have played the mod constantly between like 2012 and 2014. So I was so tired, I couldn't really hear the music in the mod anymore, because I had heard it so much that I basically was sick of it. So I had lost interest in the mod and started to play mods like Divide and Conquer and other mods from December 2014 onwards. I believe Elder Scrolls came during the spring of 2015. So, anyway, in 2016, I decided to start this submod, and it's a submod of the old Hyrule Total War version 3.8. It utilizes all the unused material of this version. Also, it adds material from the more recent 4.6 version released during the summer of 2017, and it also has some extra stuff from the Great Sea demo that Undying Nephilim, the creator of Hyrule Total War, released in December 2014 or so. I think it was back then. As a demo, it was just a demo where you could play naval battles between the ocean blinds, basically seaborne moblins, and New Hyrule, which is the kingdom of Hyrule in an era set after this era. As I have no use for ships, they aren't implemented, but all the animations from 4.6 and from Great Sea have been merged with the animations of this older version, so you can use any animation from any of the released Hyrule Total War mods, and all the units would work in this version, all the projectiles, etc. Anyway, I have just released the Hyrule Total War Classic Ultimate submod. I've been working on it alone, but it is heavily based on the work that Undying Nephilim did during the years from 2009 to 2014. Also, there are others who did community patches for it back in 2014. I believe it was Sir Lion and Tedster 1995 who made community patches that fixed various smaller bugs, including a very annoying bug where if you played as someone else than Sant, the Twille, they are two factions. You can play as Midna, you can play as Prince Sant. And if you clicked on Sant, it would crash. So the community patches fixed that issue and some other issues, and added like more general portraits, etc. So they did many, I believe it was 7 or 8 smaller patches for this version, and all of them are included. So credit for those older community patches are for Sir Lion and Tester 1995, and then Undying Nephilim is the creator of the whole mod. He has made everything in the mod, so the mod itself is his creation. However, the submod, it started in 2013 when I just decided, I was a noob back then, I was a player. I had played it very much, but I didn't have much knowledge of modding. I decided to use whatever files there was in the game, in the game's folders that weren't in use, but I lacked the skill to properly utilize all the stuff. But I did some basic stuff back then. In 2016, I decided to finally start a submod because I had learned how to mod during 2016, during the spring of 2016. So I decided to finally create a real submod out of this mod in 2016. I believe it was in November, but then other mods came in between. Like I worked on Game of Thrones Enhanced in December and during the whole fall basically. And then I worked on it during the spring of 2017. I worked on The Lost Kingdom, Wrath of the Norsemen. I worked on my Warhammer Beginning of the End Times submod that is finished. It was finished in January 2018, but I can't release it because I'd never got permission from the creators of the Sundering assets that I use. Basically, I used Sundering assets in Warhammer Beginning of the End Times for the High Elves and Dark Elves. It's a great submod, I think. It took a long time to do, but I don't dare releasing it when I don't have those permissions, because then I would risk all the other mods. Anyway, I couldn't get permission either, because the creators had disappeared from Total War Center many years earlier. But I tried reaching out to one of them, and he didn't answer, so on YouTube, so I don't dare to release it until I hear from him. Anyway, back to Hyrule Total War. I had created this submod in November 2016, and I worked on it in May of 2017. At the same time, I worked on the Lost Kingdom, the Game of Thrones mod, and the Warcraft mod was started during March 2017. So I worked in many projects, even the East of Rome mod. I have the full main campaign beta. So I worked on many mods and jumped trip between them. So this mod was never really given the proper time, but I believe I spent few weeks or days or something. I believe it was like a week maybe or two that I spent on editing models for this mod. So I added new units to the Labyrinth regime, where I like took weapons from modern units from 4.6 and added them to the old units. I also added the bears and so such. But besides that, I didn't do anything on the mod back then. I believe I also fixed the gold knuckles for Gerudo and utilized all the models for Vear in the files already. But during the spring of 2017, no, during the fall of 2017, I managed to get Majora into the game, into the campaign, without crashing, and I also got the Majora Prime custom settlement into the mod. I had tried to, you know, make Majora playable back in 2013, but every time I placed the cursor on the settlements they had, it would crash. But I learned how to fix that crash, and then I got them into the game during October of 2017. Besides that, I laid out some plans, but I didn't do much more. I believe I spent a few evenings on the mod when I was studying. Anyway, then it took very long until I went back to this mod. I believe I was busy with Warcraft Total War from like back then all the way to, I believe, maybe summer of 2018, where I finished some pictures, and then I was back at work on Warcraft again. So work on this mod started for real first during late November of 2018, where we were very active. I believe I spent like 3 weeks or a month or something, maybe 2 months, I'm not sure. But I spent a lot of time during November and such on this mod, where I added like custom settlements on the strat map everywhere. I added custom settlements in battle everywhere, etc. And then I worked on it some in December and some in January. But then after that, I believe I worked on it in February in the beginning, but then I changed focus and worked on another mod, and it was released in the beginning of March. And then I took a pause, and at the late March, I believe in the end of March, I started to go back to this mod and work on it. But I also worked on Total War 1942, but not too much, because that mod was mainly the work of Salazar and Dagovax. But I helped them with some stuff, so you can say I worked on both projects, mostly on this one, but I also switched focus to it. And I also gave Warcraft of the War an update during February, while also releasing the Republic of China mod. So basically I've been working on this mod since 2016, but most of the work have been done during the spring of 2019 and late fall of 2018. So, and for the last 3 months or so, I've been working basically constantly on this mod, with only small pauses where I worked on Total War 1942 to help Dagovax and the others with it. Instead, I did like 229 quotes, and I did some placements of troops, I did the faction descriptions, etc. But besides that, I've been working constantly on this one. I edited movies to fit the win intro and defeat categories. I have done a lot of work on the mod itself as well. And the mod is still the creation of Undying Nephilim, and the ones who worked on the community patches still have their stuff in it, because my work are based on what they left behind. So this version is their work as well, but I'm the only one who has worked on it, since it became a submod that I named Classic Ultimate. Classic because it's the older version with all units, all scripts, etc. So people who played it in 2014 and earlier will recognize the differences between this version and the new. And then Ultimate because it's been improved a lot, so it's not in the same state as it were back then. Now I'm gonna show you the changes of the mod. So the battle editor, I've added the actual Hyrule map here. It used to be a vanilla map, now it's the Hyrule map, so you can make historical battles and know where you are on the map. I don't have much skill in creating historical battles though, but I believe it's easy now when you have the proper map. So that's one thing I did. Another thing I did was that I have added more factions to the campaign. I fixed the selection screen. It used to crash in the beginning when I had less factions here, with less descriptions. It was when I clicked on the 14th faction, it would crash. But after adding nice selection screens for everyone, where I had the hero portrait here, this portrait here, and this was only text. I had this portrait here, but it was wider. like it was originally, it was the selection screen that Andy Nephilim had made, but I made new ones for the new factions, the minor factions, the Suna, the Subrosians, the Tuke, the Huskers Remnants, and the Horonians, as well as the new factions of the Uka and the Church of Miura. I made new for them, but otherwise it were the old. Basically it looked the same here, and the hero was here, and here was only text. But it seemed that it would crash, and especially since I did the new ones, then it would crash on like the second or the first faction I clicked on, or the second faction I clicked on. So yeah, it was very annoying when you clicked on two factions and then the mod crashed. And the reason for it was that the game can't handle too many map pictures. This is the map picture, but I've changed stuff, so now the mod thinks that this is the special unit portrait, and instead the map slot has been moved to where the special unit used to be, because there is a limit on how many map pictures you can have. There are 31 factions in the game in total. If you have 31 map pictures, then you can't click on any faction without a crash. So if you have like one picture, you can click on everyone, because the first is automatically clicked on or activated. So basically, the more map pictures you have, the sooner the crash happens and you click factions. And by changing the slots I can have, because there are no limits to the special unit pictures, so by changing this I can have all the special unit pictures, the old map pictures, and then instead I move the special unit here, and I'm using this cover here, so it's just one picture for all the factions, so I never have to worry about the crash now, because it can handle one picture. But had I added more, then it would sooner or later crash when clicking the factions. Instead I moved here or here, but I had to cut off the picture, because otherwise the text would not. So that's what I did. I fixed the crash in the selection screen and added more factions. You can play the minor factions, and you can play the Uka and Majora, and also the old factions, also the Twilight have both Sant and Midna, and all the old scripts are in the mod. So I've added regionals, I've added lots of stuff. It's basically a new experience. Maybe we should enter the campaign and show some stuff. Let's enter this Kingdom of Hyrule. I haven't added any videos or cinematic packages to this version yet, so there are no videos playing, but of course there exists videos for the intro for most factions. Only the ones where NEP didn't create videos doesn't have them, so the small faction doesn't have videos, and some factions close to Labyrinth, like Labyrinth, doesn't have win and defeat videos, and Zebrosha, the Fairies of Tarm, etc., they don't have videos, but most others have videos. So I don't have music on, because it's copyrighted. So the events from the old version are in, as you can see. Every faction starts without units, so if you click to GIL FOV, you can see that all areas with the exception of some rebel areas are empty at the start, because all the units will spawn on second turn, through the campaign script. They aren't added in the Desk Strat. And they Nephilim used the campaign script instead. Now if you click here, we can see that they have more that the Kingdom of Hyrule is allied to all the other good factions, and then the evil factions are allied. This is because I disliked being attacked by like the Gorons or the Kokiri, the first thing that happened if playing as Hyrule, or being attacked by Hyrule when playing as the Kokiri, etc. They still have their old goals. As you can see, all such regions, including Ashnon, Demise, all of them have their old goals. So the Sora still need to defeat the Gorons, and the Gorons still need to defeat Sora. But they start allied to prevent, you know, backstabbing good factions from attacking you when you are fighting like the Gerudo or something. But if sooner or later they will, as the AI, attack the ones they should attack, and as the player you are free to do so, and of course the AI can attack you, but they are less likely to do it when you start allied, so you get more of a breathing space. The Goma are too far away, they usually attack Lanayur and the Visrobe, and do not get to the forest. I've seen the Kokiri reach all the way here, but that's very late game, like turn 200 something. So you need to play very long campaigns to see the Kokiri reach the Goma. But if you play as them, you can of course just send troops there. But AI takes a lot longer, because it would take a lot of areas here and move up like this. Anyway, I've added custom models to all the strat, to the strat map. I've added resources from 4.6. I've added regionals. For example, if any faction take this area, with the exception of Majora and Uka, I think the Uka too, but not Majora, because they have already a lot of rosters. So if you take this area, you get the Crown Ridge Gorons. The one who is holding it gets them. If you take this area, you get Tukey. And you can also get Tukey from most areas here, because they are mercenaries. And then you can get the Storm Sora from this place, their capital. And then, because their real capital, that is placed somewhere here, isn't in this older version, the map is different, it's smaller, and their capital wasn't there, so I took the closest area, the Fort of Hills. Then the Korkiloki settlement has Ulvegians, rebels. If you take it, you get Ulvegians. The only unit you don't get is the Mother of Dragons. All the others are available there. And then, of course, if you hold the area down here, Messian, you get Kuis, because Majora has this area as their capital. You can change the settlement name easily. So you can change that settlement to Majora Prime by double-clicking here and just removing the name and write in a new name. Can change name of all settlements, but especially if you play Majora, you might need to change this to Majora Prime for it to look right. The Puis isn't located here, because I thought this was the perfect spot for Majora, so the Puis have been moved here instead. Then we have the Picori that can be recruited here in the Picori Ruins, and the Stalfos is starting with this region, so they can recruit them. It's a Picori unit, and also golems and such, armors and golems. There is the Khitan area here. You can recruit all the Khitan units, including the old unit, to take it. Then we have the Dodongus Cavern, which will be crowded with beasts, etc. You won't get any special unit there, but you can get the Dodongus if you play as the Gorons. And you can get the Ulvegians if you take Korkiloki, as I said. And besides those units, I don't believe there are any there, with the exception of Trinex, but it's a boss unit, so it can only be killed. There spawn animals here, like Moldarach and Arachas and Arurodas, but they cannot be recruited. The Lanayuru can recruit Aerorodas, but not the Arachas or the Moldarak, so they are unique to the wildlife. And then here there are some rebel areas, etc. And if you take these areas, you won't get any special units, but this area is basically crowded with beasts, animals, and same with this area, while there are river Sora here. You can conquer the smaller factions, but you can also make them enter an alliance with you, the Horons, the Subrotians, the Huskus Remnants, the Suna, which is much stronger now. They have all the units from the recent version. And of course the Tokay too, they have all the units from the recent version. And then I've added new units to most factions. I've especially added new units to the Dark Knight Legion, to the Kingdom of Hyrule, and I believe I added some units to the Fairies as well, and to Stalfos. Stalfos has their unique necromancer script. Basically they start with many regions, and in each region they can recruit different units. They have certain types of units that are made by any skeletons, really. Like they can construct them out of any bone. Those kinds of creatures, monsters, like the Stall Lord, or the Stall Lord, or like the Stall Troops, etc. Those kinds of undead monsters are available from any region. And then they have like the fairies only from here, the Sora only from here, the Dekus only from this area, here from Hikori Ruins. They can get the Kokiri undead. In Kadalukshrut they can get the Lissalfos undead. In Sulcarco they can get the Shrek and Hylian undead. Then in Exexoblin they can get the Moblin undead, in Aslasus, and in Paladorf they can get the Gerudo, and in Tentare they can get the Dark Knight undead. And of course they have the siege engines in any of the areas, while the Stall Troops etc. are only available, I believe, from the human, or the Stall soldiers are only available from the human and Shrake areas. And human as in Hillen, Odunna, Labrinna, Gerudo, etc. etc. Maybe not Gerudo, because they have their own undead. So that's their starting situation, and the way they can recruit troops from the start. But they have the necromancer script. So if you win if you win battles as the Stalfos, you can get new troops where you have your necromancer. A necromancer is basically a Skite Lord with a special name that is that you will have to have in a city. Then if you win a battle here and you have a necromancer here, then after you win the battle, you will earn some troops based on the troops you fought in the closest area where the necromancer is. So you would get, if you beat a Kokiri army here, you would get Kokiri undead here. If you beat an army here and you have the necromancer here, you get the types of undead based on the army you beat. So it's pretty cool. And you have the Visrobe script, where you can like send priests to other regions and take them over by converting them. It's very overpowered and broken in a sense, because at a certain point you can just place them somewhere and you get the area. But the AI doesn't know how to use them properly, so it's just the player who can misuse this function. If the AI is controlling the Visceral, they will act as any normal faction. But as the player you can, send priests and conquer the entire world, basically. But you won't have troops, so if you send a priest here and you won't have any troops here, it will revolt sooner or later, but it will turn to you, and then it will revolt. So those features, they are old, and they are features that Andai and Nephilim implemented. We have the Shreika stances, where you can choose to have battle stance or shadow stance. Battle stance means that you basically get your heroes and your troops, and they move into Caparico. If the Hylians are holding it, you get it, and the Hylians are thrown out. And it's up to the Hylians if they want to attack you and take it back, or if they accept the situation. But you get like heroes like Azrael, Aghanim, and Impa, and then they move in here together with an army, and then you can play ordinary. Or if you take the shadow stance, then you won't have this area, and Hyrule will probably control it, but then you can use your agents. You start with some agents, and you can probably play in different ways. I haven't really played with the shadow stance, but it's an alternative to the battle stance. And then we have the Ikana. They were supposed to spawn late game, but they spawn in the beginning. They spawn, and then they act as an ordinary faction, but it's pretty cool. And then we have the Sola script, the River Sora. They're called Sola in the files to differ from the Sora, but they have a script too, where they, if you recruit units in cities, they will not show up in the cities, they will show up close to rivers, and it's scripted where they will show up, etc. It's pretty vast, that script as well. They are a barbaric savage faction that doesn't hold cities, so that's why Nep made it like that. So I recommend all of those factions because they have unique ways of playing. As for the Oka faction that I've added, they have a limited number of units because Nep didn't finish the faction roster for them. But they have at least 5 Oka units, and then they have the goddesses units, at least 5 more, and then they have some armors, etc. They have very strong units, and they start with 1 strong army and 25 in religious level, which are required for them to build a church, and the church is required to build their basic units, and then you need to upgrade the church to get the rest of your units, but in order to upgrade you need higher levels of religion, so that's their weakness, because they are supposed to be in a sky city high above in the air, and it's not very likely that they could get reinforcements very easily. So you start with a great army, 1 army, but very strong. You can easily take a few areas from the start, but then when you start to lose troops, you need to use priests to get more. When you have reached the final level here, you can get all the troops here, but then if you take this area, you need to use priests to increase the religious level. So it will be a much slower expansion because you need the area to be at a certain level of religion before you can get more of their troops from the new area. The Majora faction, they have a unique situation. They start with an army, with half the army being basically Hylians, Majora Hylians, and with Majora Zelda as the hero. You also have Majora himself as a single man unit, giant unit, but then you can... Oh, the Oka and the Majora factions can adopt people. That was required because they have no generals in the script. The other factions have get all the generals through the script, so you can actually recruit generals in the building queue, and then the script will make sure they get correct portraits and names, etc. So you don't have to worry about them looking wrong, etc. But with the adoptions, unfortunately, they can get like vanilla portraits that doesn't fit, but I had no choice because they don't have any tries, and the only way was to like add their leaders to the desert strat, and then adoptions happen automatically. So if you place the Oka or the Majora, then you get adoptions, but that's a good way of getting fast generals. And Miura has a very good general. Doka has also a very good general, but Miura's is more badass looking, I guess. But anyway, the Miura faction has its demons available from all areas they take. But they also have the region specific troops. This is not this city in battle, it's the Miura prime city seen in the final battle mission. And Hylians are recruitable here together with the demons, but they can also get the Avatar of Miura Twilight unit here, Twilight unit. Then if they take Uruna areas, they get the Uruna troops. If they take Ikana areas, they get the Ikana shamans and their demons. If they take Moblin areas, they get Moblin troops. If they take Stalfos areas, they can only make their own demons. But if Stalfos are holding the Moblin area, then they can make Moblins. If they're holding a Darknut area, they can make Darknuts. So it depends on if they're holding areas that belongs to others. And basically the same for most factions. The only factions they can't get units from are the Goma, because they are not religious. They are a swarm faction of insects or creatures. And then the Order of the Visro, because they are basically a religious faction of their own that follow Hylia, so it would be odd if they could follow two faiths at once. And then the Stalfos, because they are undead, and Ikana and Twilight, because they are allied with those factions, they have the same fate, which is Majora fate, or Majora worship. And the River Sora, because they are barbaric savages that doesn't probably have a fate, but I'm not sure. Anyway, I didn't think they fit. All the others, with the exception of the Uka, because that's their rival, do have like Miura variations. So if Miura takes their areas, then they get their troops. That's pretty cool. And they have unique rebels in many places, and unique animals and such. And we have new projectiles, we have new animations, we have new mercenaries. Like we have the Rito units in this area, not just the Gerudo pirates like before, but also the Rito units, pretty cool. And we have the Ocean Blins here somewhere. It's very expanded in that way. We have the custom settlements in battle as well, so this city is this city in battle, this city is this city in battle. And the same goes for all the regions. We have used the Linna City without a tower settlement here for all the Labrinna regions, and used the unused version with the tower as the capital. So we differ, we make the capital stand out from the rest by using this for the capital and the others for all the other areas. In battle it used the tower, but I managed to remove the tower, so in these other areas they won't have the tower, but in this area they will have it. So I've added the 4.6 resources to the map, so it looks better. I have all the agents from the old version, but I've also added agents from the new where I could. So there are much more agents, many more variations of agents. I didn't keep Nep's style of like 3 agents per faction. Some factions have 5 agents, others have 3. So a lot of work have been done here. I managed to remove the annoying crash to desktop where you click exterminate after a battle or ransom and it becomes exterminate because they declined your ransom. Previously if you clicked exterminate after winning against the odds, if you won a great battle against the odds, where you won against a very big army of enemy troops, and you clicked exterminate or clicked ransom and they declined, then it would crash. I believe I have managed to remove that crash, so now it's way more playable. I also believe it was due to that issue with the selection screen, because when I solved that crash, some of the other with the extermination seemed to have disappeared too. As for the transgressor error, which was a crash that happened randomly. You can could restart it and play like one or two turns, then it would happen again. And when you restarted it after that, you could never continue because it would happen at the same time again and again and again. I managed to somehow remove that crash. I believe it was the civilian script that caused it, but the problem was that before I added my civilian stuff, I believe it wasn't activated, and still I had a crash back then, so I don't know how it disappeared when removing the civilian script, but I'm happy it did. Usually I get the crash at turn 41, then I can restart and continue play for hundreds of turns. I never got a crash after that, but I never played more than like 200 something turns after that, 250 turns maybe, 256. Anyway, it's very stable, but expect a crash during like turn 41, and then you can restart and play. And looking in the log, it said something about Southern culture or something, but I couldn't get anything out of it. So expect the campaign to be much improved compared to in the past, if you played it in the past. And expect something different if you have never played the old version before, because this version has the old armies and many units from the recent versions and the Great Sea units all in this version in various roles. And it has the old scripts by Undying Nephilim, it has all these features I've just spoken about. So expect something new if you have never played the old versions, and expect something old in a new updated form if you play the old version before. Also, let's take a look at the custom battles. So, enabled, we have all these factions here. You can't click enabled and then use Majora, it will crash. Because enabled, we have disabled, we have no heroes, we have no mercs, and we have enabled. Enabled means you enable all the units for a certain faction that are available in the EDU file. If you have no heroes, yeah, it's self-explanatory, same with no mercs. So you could test without mercs, and the Majora faction has 200 units, which is the limit. These are all the units that are available for no mercs. I couldn't add the final ones because it would crash. If you have more than 200, it will crash. So this is their roster. But if you click enable and try to use Majora, then it will crash because you overstep that limit of 200 units. You can use no heroes too, and disabled. Disabled is no heroes and no mercs. And no heroes means you have no heroes. I'm not sure the difference here. I believe enabled everything. Here is no mercs, but you still have the heroes. Here you have no heroes, so you have like only your roster, and disabled. I'm not really sure what the difference is between those, but as you can see also, when I fix this faction selection screen, I also increase the number of slots here, so I can have all the minor factions and the Uka, Miura, and the Wildlife faction here. The Wildlife faction, which is we won't use enabled, no mercs instead. Then you see I give them a roster of their own in custom battles. So I originally wanted them to be playable in the campaign as well. But unlike the other factions, they won't have any recruitment because I never did it. And the reason I never did the recruitment is because they have the function that they can convert cities. They can convert the settlements from one type to another. They can convert cities to castles and castles to cities. This will turn your custom models on the map and in battle to the vanilla models. And that is a feature that Undying Nephilim removed, because he wanted original to have unique custom settlements that looked unique on every single area. But he never finished that. And I have use that system to paint the map in unique models, but using the same for like the deck, because there was only one to use. I had no others. So basically I've done what he intended, but with the limited settlement models that I had at hand. And this faction can convert them to vanilla cities. They never do when they are holding the Drongos Cavern, but if I added recruitment to them, like different beasts in different areas that they can recruit, then of course they would take areas and then convert them, and you'd see like vanilla settlements popping up everywhere. That's not what I intended when I added custom models everywhere. So because of this issue, they will remain NPC, non-playable, and also they have the function that if you remove their name in the EDB, then from the convert city lines, then you enable it for everyone else, because this faction is somehow connected to the others not being able to convert cities. So if you try to make it possible for these guys, then you enable it instead for the others. So this faction should remain non-playable. Think about it, that it's wild animals on the map. Only the Volvagians make sense to have playable. The others doesn't make sense. They are wild animals. They wouldn't use rams and stuff and siege cities. The Volvagians probably could take cities, but then again, you have them in Korkloc. If you take Korkloc, you can have these units as their regional troops, but this unit won't be available because it's a hero unit, and she is located in the Dodonus Cavern together with other monster creatures, because I thought that settlement looked the best for creatures with that. We have the new Uka faction. We have the two old Uka units and the three new units. But I've added bodyguard as well, because it's needed when they are their own faction. They have the goddess units, the Gibdos, the Silent Stalker and the Silent Guards and the Echo Valiants. Then they have the Vine Tribe Armas and the Minish Armas and the Minish Golems, because they are connected to the Wind Tribe. And the Uka used to be Wind Tribe before they became Uka. So anyway, the goddesses also have the same goal as the Uka when it comes to finding the tree forms. We have the ancient Hylians. They aren't playable either, because they are the old Hylians from old Hyrule. And they have some units. I've added the Managed Armors and the Managed Golems to them from 4.6. I've added the old Wind Tribe Armors to them, because why not? They have the Wind Tribe here. And Fee and etc. As for the factions, Hyrule, Gerudo, Gorons, the Kokiri. The Goma hasn't got anything new, so they only have the old roster. Everyone else here have gotten something new. I will talk about it soon. The Deku tribes didn't get anything new. The Moblins have something. Darkness have something. Let's take a look at them. So, the Kingdom of Hyrule, they have their old roster, but they also have this unit from Great Sea Total War. They have the unit, the Surveyors, as well, but it's a mercenary unit. I forgot to change that. So if you have mercenaries enabled, you can see it. I could change it, probably. Enabled, yes. Can see this unit from Great Sea and this unit from Great Sea. They have them in the campaign. They are late units, late era units, comparable to the gunpowder units in Vanilla Medieval 2, because they are supposed to be units of the new Hyrule together with this unit. So they are late era units, despite being kind of sucky, because they are the early units of the new Hyrule roster, while this is like an upgraded knight. So they are late era new units for Kingdom of Hyrule, and then we have custom battle only units. like in Gusta, the ancient knights, the ancient archers, the ancient mages, Loftwing cavaliers, and the wind tribe soldiers. The wind tribe is basically the Ukka before they became the Ukka, so they can't be in the campaign. And the ancient Hylians, they had them in the campaign for a while, but they removed them, they didn't fit. So they have their old roster, and they have the new units from Great Sea in the late era of the game. And then they have some heroes, they have Kazak, they have Link, you can recruit Ashay close to Labrina, you can recruit Malan close to London Ranch, and yeah, you have the three first vanguards, the special unit when Hyrule Prime is besieged, you have the Princess Zelda Hyrule Warriors only in custom battles, and Princess Tralina Zelda only in custom battles. The reason is because it would be odd to have many Zeldas at once. The other Zeldas, like Zelda 1 is the first Zelda, 3 is the one you start with, then after a certain turn you can get Zelda 2 if Zelda 1 dies. For example, if Zelda 1 dies, you can get Zelda 2 at about turn 50. If she dies after turn 50, she will spawn immediately. If she dies long before that, you will have to wait. Same with 3 dies. You will have all the Zeldas in order from Zelda 1 to Zelda 5. That's all scripts by NAP. But I don't know how to add new Zeldas to that script, and therefore these Zeldas are only in custom battles. But I added Kazak and I've added Link. Akaza is only in custom battles because he's the undead leader in the campaign. You can't have a live Akaza in the same campaign as undead, because it would be odd if they face each other. The ancient mages and the Loftwing cavaliers, I've added them to the area of Vigyaro, Visrobe's capital, because the Visrobe have the ancient Hylians as a unit, or Hylian mages, they are the same unit basically. So I thought if the Kingdom of Hyrule takes that area, they deserve to get ancient mages, and I like this unit. So the Loftwings, they are supposed to be dead. They are supposed to be have died out by this time, but what is to say mages can't resurrect them? I mean, come on, it's fantasy. So therefore I let Hyrule get these two units if they take Vigyaro, but they start with it, but soon after the start of the game the Visrobe will take it. You can hand it to them and have them as an ally, or you could refuse and they will spawn an army and take it anyway, and you will have war. So you won't get it at the start, but if you take it after a war or something, you'll get this unit. So they have some new units, they have new heroes, they have the Fee hero that I found in files, the Princess Zelda Hyrule Warriors that I got after supporting NAP in 2014 through Patreon, and the Tretralina Zelda that I got when he sent me the Great Sea demo when I asked for it and told him about the mod in like 2017 or something. So that's their situation. As you can see, I've added lots of mercenaries, including these Rita units from Great Sea. So lots of stuff from the recent version. And we have Oduna Province, where I've added the Half Clock and the War Wagons, because I had no choice but to remove the old Shepherds and the old Hawkmen, because they used the animal handler slot, and there is a limit of 2 animal handlers in the game, and the Ukka is using that. They are only using one, but for some reason the other one was glitched, so when using the Ukka model, so I needed to replace those two units with two others. Unfortunately, they had a Hawk Clock, so it replaced the Hawkmen. The Hawkmen, they're basically humans with hawks. These are just hawks. And then the Shepherds, they're humans with basically goats, but instead they now have the War Wagons. So that's the new stuff for Oduna, and they replaced two older units. Then we have the Gerudo. I found these units in files. This was the bodyguard of Ganondorf. I made it a unit on its own. And then we have the Gold Knuckles. They are supposed to have been like an officer for the Aeronautics, but they couldn't use the animation without looking glitched. I made it their own unit. I thought it was cool. So they are like the Gold Knuckles instead, the Iron Knuckles in stats, but Iron Knuckles have better attack and these have better defense. Then they have the Atlanta Euro Province. They have the, of course, the Rito mercenaries are available to them in the campaign, but otherwise they have the Atlanta Euro Mages from Great Seat of War. But you can only get them in the campaign if you take the Sword Dominion lands only there. Because they are not Lana Yuru Sora, they are Sora Dominion Sora. And so you need their lands to get them. Then we have the Gorons, they added the Sumos to them. Otherwise they have the old units. The Moblins, they have the old units, but I've added the new Hinox unit from version 4.6. And I've added the unused Girahim unit that I found in the files. A single man unit with very unique animations, just like Fi, very cool. You should check them out in battle. Then they also have the mercenary Ocean Limbs, a cool unit from Great Sea, used as the crewmen on the ships, the only unit that is available. You know, Undying Nephilim. Undying Nephilim, he finished all the rosters of the Great Sea Total War planned expansion. He previewed all of the units for all the rosters, all the ships, all the heroes, all the units. But he never rigged most of the units. Only the new Hyrule faction was properly rigged. But he never finished the textures for half the roster. So even though the models are in the files, in the released version and available to anyone, the textures doesn't seem to have certain units. And as such, I couldn't include units like the Tree Force, and like the Iron Tree Force, I think it was, and like the Red Lion Knights. There were some cool units that unfortunately didn't have textures. I've added the ones that had. Yeah, Girahim was a unit that I found in the files that we had used. Hero Sume was another unit in the files. I made the portraits that are like this, that doesn't have a cool background. All those portraits are by me. I've added to the Dark Knight Legion. I've added the basic Unitai unit, the Hoplites, and the Peltasts from the 4.6 version. Then I've added the Rebonax and the Lin of Pride because they lacked distance units and they lacked cavalry, and then also they had very few basic units. I thought it didn't matter because these doesn't impact on the style. I think they fit very well. And then I fixed this unit, Vati Rat, and added it as a single man unit as well. And I've added Idol, which is basically a Gimnitai moving this around to increase morale. I've added it from 4.6. This unit wasn't from 4.6, this was an old unit, but it was glitched, etc. I fixed it. It had glitched textures. Anyway, that was those units. Let's take a look at the other half of units. Lisselfoss doesn't have anything new. Labrinnar Dream has a lot of new stuff. We have new stuff for the Fairies of Tom. We have new stuff for the Stalfos. We have new stuff for the Shreika. The Kingdom of Canada doesn't have anything new. The Santa faction has something new. Visrub has something. And I believe the River Sura doesn't have anything new. I've added nothing to the I've added the 4.6 units to Suna, I've added nothing to Subrosia, I've added 4.6 units to Takei, and I've added nothing to the Huskies Remnants, I've added nothing to Horonians, and you've seen the Uka and the Majora, where I have added lots of stuff to Majora and some stuff to Uka, and then, wildlife and ancient things. let's take a look at these. I've made the portraits that look like this, but still I have made variations for the Labyrinthary frame. So you can see I've added this cool rifle to the old models and created Assault Rifle Dragoon in an old form. So it's a unit from 4.6 that I've copied by using the old model with the new weapon. And then I did the same with a pistol. I found I have the Great Sea Hero Lindbeck that I had planned to use but didn't in the end because there was no room for it. And it had a unique pistol in the old style that fitted the planned bodyguard of the Labyrinth Gunners. So I added that pistol to the Rifleman, this unit, and therefore got Pistolman. Then I mounted these Pistolmen on the new bears from 4.6 that I imported, and therefore I created the Blue Dragoons in an old style. It's the new Blue Bears from 4.6 with the old Labyrinth Gunners model with the gun that Lindbeck had. It was planned to be used as a weapon of a Pistolman unit that would be his bodyguard. Then I've added grenades that I thought fit the Labyrinthians. Actually, they are from Warcraft of the War, the grenades, but I thought they fit, so yeah, they look very suitable for the Labyrinthians. Because I don't know how to create models, so I took them from there. So, yeah. Anyway, the Twilight Faction, I added some units from the Midna faction to it, because they had all the units in the campaign but they didn't have the ownership, so I added the ownerships because otherwise I was afraid it would crash or something during gameplay. I forgot the portrait for Algorok, the hero dragon for the Santa faction. I remember now that I saw that before releasing and thought I would fix it as a final thing to do, but they probably failed to remember and release it anyway. And yeah, I've forgotten the portrait. If you want to fix that, you can just move the portrait for Algorok from the UI. If you go into the data folder and then into the UI folder, and you see units folder and the units info folder, both those folders have portraits. You go into the units folder where the unit cards are, and then you move the Algorok portrait from the, you copy the Algorok portrait from the Midna folder to the Santi folder to give the portrait to Santi as well. Then you go back to the UI folder, and inside of it you also had the unit info folder, which is the portrait when you right click on the units, and then you move the portrait from Midna to Santi. You copy it so you don't take it from Midna, so Free get this instead. Instead you copy it so both get the same portrait. So you can take it from there because the portrait exists. I just forgot to place it in the folder for Sand. And that was those units. For the Favorites of Tarm, I've added some units from the recent 4.6 version, so there are some units from there that I thought fit. This unit is very neutral, this unit looks a lot like a Fairy Queen, and this unit fits very well with the Corrigans here, Citra, and then we have these, they look very fitting as well. I couldn't add new Mad Mystics that I find very good looking, but couldn't because this fit better with the overall roster. It also looked too high quality, so it would make all the other models look bad in comparison. And then we have the Lanayur I've already previewed. The Stalfos, they have the old army, but they've added like the neutral looking units from the 4.6 version. So we have the Staldra, we have the Stallmasters, we have the Battleforged, and we have the Lost Souls. I also fixed the texture of the Battleforged, as well as the LOD problem with the Banshees, where you moved out, you zoomed out, then they would disappear, that's fixed. And then we have the Shrake, I have added the Gold Rats and the Murder Crows to it. And then of course to the Visrog faction I've added these Crystalline Construct Giants, because they have that in the video, and I thought they were cool and would be old if they weren't even. They also do not affect the look of stuff. So they felt okay to be added. So now you've seen basically most things I can preview, and yeah, there are a lot of stuff in the campaign. You will see the difference. And besides that, we have the Hyrule Historia, where I unfortunately couldn't make the other missions work, and they still didn't have the videos, but these missions have videos. You need to download the missions separately from the mod level page, the same with all the cinematics. But basically you have all the Gerudo Wars missions working, but I had to remove like heroes. I am using heroes as the generals, so at least one hero will be in all the battles where heroes are. But if there were like many heroes in an army, then I replaced that hero with only the bodyguards. So, because heroes can be generals, but you can't have more than one general per army. So if there were like an army with many heroes, then you can't use the other heroes in that army anymore, and instead you use just their bodyguard. That's why Nep probably had units for all the heroes. We can use could use many heroes in the Hyrule Historia missions, but by removing the heroes from custom battles and Hyrule Historia, I managed to get more units into the campaign, and I thought that was more important. If you want to play the Hyrule Historia with heroes, you still have the hero with like the main hero leading the army. If you want the other heroes, you'd need to download the older version of the mod and play the Hyrule Historia there. But I believe the Hyrule Historia missions that are coming with the 3.8 version, they are outdated. They don't have fixing. Like, for example, in this version, I fixed all the issues where, like, for example, the battles against the Gorons versus the Sora. If you fight like in the Dungus Cavern, they would spawn like a vanilla settlement. I believe in my submod, it's the proper Dungus Cavern, but in the 3.8 version, you will have a vanilla settlement. That's true for at least two places, and you won't have Majora Prime working either. So by using my submod, you get all the missions working as you should, but without more than one hero per mission, per army in the missions. If you use the 3.8 version, you get lots of issues like Silver Surfers and such, but then you get all the heroes. But you could download the missions from Mod DB to the old version, and you get them fully working with all the heroes as Nep intended. But as I said, there are benefits in my submod, such as a lot more units in the campaign and many other units in the custom battles instead of heroes. So that depends on what you want. Play the old version with the mission download from Mod DB to get it like he wanted and intended, and play my submod if you want a much grander campaign, or if you don't bother playing with the missions without more than one hero per army. So that's it. I fixed like issues here. I fixed the Majora Prime mission. It has the videos playing. They didn't exist in the old version. And then I've remade the music, the script for the music, so it plays. The videos existed, but not with the download, so I had to like recreate the videos by downloading from under NFLM's YouTube. So yeah, the missions can be played in a fixed form here without heroes, and if you want to play them as he wanted originally, you can download the old version from the Hyrule Total War forum at Total War Center. And yeah, that's it. I've added, you know, videos to the campaign. If you start a campaign, as most factions, the intro videos will play. I reworked Andai Nephilim's Hyrule Historia videos to fit the intro win, defeat, and death categories. So when you start a campaign as most factions, you get a unique video playing. And when you are defeated, you get the video playing. When you defeat others, you get a video playing. And when you win or when they win, videos will play. But you need to download the videos separately, the cinematic packages, as show you have in the other video. So I've uploaded missions and Hyrule Historia missions, Hyrule Wars, and the campaign cinematics separately. If you download the new Hyrule Total War of the Classic Ultimate, Hyrule Total War Classic Ultimate, then you won't get the missions and you won't get the cinematic packages. They aren't coming with the download. You only get the mod itself. So if you want the videos and if you want the missions, you need to download them separately from ModDB. But they are all compatible. So that was all I wanted to say. This became longer than I had intended, and I'm getting tired of talking. I'm not used to talking English. I'm a Swedish guy, and also I need to drink something. But yeah, that was it. Thank you for listening and enjoy the mod. See ya.